Tom, we have a very special guest in the house.
We do. He's going to be lucky to be getting some delicious burgers or steaks this morning. Mm-hmm. He is Sam Miller.
Hello.
Look, a guy with a hearty appetite, I'm guessing.
Hello. I eat a lot of food.
Hi, Sam.
Yeah, he's already.
He's got a football build, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm not trying to say anything disparaging. I mean, he looks like...
I'm huge.
how tall are you, Sam?
I'm 6'6", 360 pounds.
Yeah, whoa. Big dude. Big dude, yeah.
That's
big
like
dude.
A defensive end at Alabama.
Yeah.
That's like three of me.
Not into college. But I'd go.
Sure.
So. Sam, how old are you?
I am 40.
40, okay, yeah. Had you just recently turned 40 or because it took
no,
you a
I
second.
Turned 40 in December. They just kind of, these years have really like come at me fast. You
know? I don't know anything about you. I've talked to you for like 30 seconds. Married, single?
I'm totally married.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah, it's intense.
Is it?
Yeah. I met my wife. It's funny. I actually met my wife when I was homeless. I was 4 months sober and still homeless when I met her. But I didn't tell her that.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that's a deal break.
So obviously, your place or mine didn't come up.
You know, she was like, can we go back to your place? And I was like, me and my roommates, we're not getting along right. Right now. My roommates were seagulls.
They are hard to get along with.
Oh, yeah. Talking, taking my food.
Yeah. I mean, technically, if you were like in a car and she said, can we go back to your place? You said, stop the car. We're here.
Yeah.
It's pretty much anywhere you
where
are.
Where were you living? Like, on, were you?
I lived in a lot of places. I lived in abandoned houses. I lived on a porch couch for a long time.
Okay.
I've lived in tents.
Did the people know that you were on their porch couch?
Yeah. My friend Mark. Yeah, he's
he
a good guy.
He didn't invite you inside?
You didn't want me inside. I wasn't really an inside kind of guy. Like not at night.
Like people have outdoor cats and indoor cats.
An outdoor roommate?
He's an outdoor Sam.
Now, was this in a temperate climate? Where were you?
No, I was in Washington State. In the summer, it's nice, though.
Sure, but I mean in the winter.
In the winter, it got kind of hairy, but I would hide at my mom's house. My mom said I could stay at her house if I was sober.
Okay.
Like she had good boundaries, but I wasn't going to be sober.
Yeah.
So I was like, I'd rather be chilly than sober.
But you're sober now.
Yeah, you know what? Next, actually in 5 days, I'll have 15 years sober.
Oh, June 10th. Yes. That's
wait.
Great.
June 10th. What day is it?
June 9th.
Oh, it's tomorrow. I'm 15 years sober.
All right.
I like a guy that doesn't know how old he is and doesn't know what day
well,
it is.
Well, he's out of brain cells and such. Yeah.
Sobriety doesn't bring back the ones that you lost.
No. Right.
Well, congratulations, man.
Yeah, that's I good. Take recovery really seriously, and I'm grateful. A lot of my fans that I've met are sober people. The best messages I get are other people that are like, hey, I quit doing meth, and I really like your jokes, and I love that. That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool. So, you're married now and housed, I assume?
Yeah. Okay, yeah, we bought. Right. I'm a homeowner.
Wow. Nice.
Yeah.
Your wife works?
Yeah. That's the keeping the dream alive.
You're home full now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I was actually president of my HOA.
No way.
Yeah. I didn't like it. I thought it'd be funny because I could like write jokes about it, but it was just really dumb.
Tom loves HOAs.
Yeah, usually it's some retired guy that had a crappy job that never got to boss anybody around, and now he can come over and tell people who work hard and have a lot more money than he does what to do with their front lawn.
Yeah, it is. He's dead on. Did you handle money, or were you also the treasurer of the...
No, I think it was mostly a ceremonial position.
You were a figurehead?
Well, it was weird because they'd be like, oh, so-and-so's, their grass is too long. And I'm like, it was like, I just want to have like cars in my yard. Like I grew up in Spanaway, Washington, and like, you know, yard couches, tarps. But they were like, oh, his lawn. I'm like, it's fine.
He's only got two washers out there. It's no big deal.
Yeah.
We're speaking with comedian Sam Miller. Sam Miller is out there on the road, and you can find him at sammillercomedy.com. Some great clips of you online. Some really funny stuff. But you are a very big guy. Would you say 6'6"?
6'6", 360, yeah.
Wow, and sober for 15 years?
15 years.
Do you mind if I ask what your drink of choice was back in the day?
Meth.
Yeah.
That's a pretty good drink.
I didn't know that it was now available as a liquid.
You can put it in anything.
I started with weed because I heard it was a gateway drug.
You wanted to work your way up.
Yeah, and it was like, weed, psychedelics, alcohol, cocaine, methamphetamine. And then, and it got really bad, but also it was really awesome sometimes. I don't know.
But you got your head clear and you're okay now.
For the most part, I mean, being a human being is like hard. And I take recovery really seriously, and I'm lucky. I have a wonderful family, a wonderful community, and I get to do stand-up comedy for a living now, and that's
great. So you should be proud of yourself. We're proud of you, man.
Yeah, I'm pretty proud of myself most of the time.
You should. I'm not being mean when I ask this. Are those your teeth?
Yeah.
Okay, because of the meth thing, I want to make sure you can eat steak.
I don't mind it at all.
Okay.
Yeah. Those are indeed my teeth. I missed the teeth thing because I did meth for 8 years, but a lot of that time I was in jail. So
they make you brush and floss?
No, I just couldn't do meth.
Yes, I guess it would be harder.
Yeah, I was in rehab.
You know something? I got to tell you, I didn't get it either until just now. Yeah, is from the great Northwest. He is comedian Sam Miller.
Sasquatch country.
Sam is a very big guy. Looks like he could be a lineman in the NFL.
I'm huge.
Yeah, you're a big fella. 6'6", what'd you say, 340?
No, 360. It's actually 370. But I say 360. The treadmill, I've been doing cardio because I found out I have high cholesterol.
Uh-huh.
And the treadmill, it's like, how much do you weigh before I start running? And I have to lie and say 350 because that's the max weight.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Otherwise, it won't start.
Nice. And we've learned a little bit about you. You have a couple of sons. I think you said they were 10 and 12.
Mm-hmm.
You are married.
Mm-hmm.
You are 15 years sober tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
Did you get sober before you went to jail?
No.
Okay.
No, it's usually the other way around.
I'm just asking.
Yeah. No, I went to jail and then I got sober. And actually, the last couple of years, I didn't go to jail at all. Yeah, it was a wild scene. Jail sucks. They won't even let you leave.
Not even like on a long weekend? You can have a fun Labor Day?
Yeah, it was bad.
Did you have the tattoos before you went to jail?
Oh, yeah. People ask me this. People ask me a lot of times, like, what it was like being, what it was like with the meth. And I always show people, can I show you my tattoo?
Yes, please.
Because
I see him on your arms. He's picking up your belly.
Whoa. Oh, okay. And it says,
let's dance.
Let's dance.
On your belly.
Yeah. Are you a Bowie fan? Or?
No.
No, a meth fan. That's the tattoo you get.
Did you get that in prison or pre?
No. I got this from a guy in OMAC for a bag of dope.
I'm confused.
Yeah. I always tell folks, like, if you want to know if you have a problem with drugs or alcohol, just read your belly tattoo.
It should let you know.
Yeah, and I don't even like to dance. I was on one.
Was that your idea to put it there?
Yeah.
And did you write the words, let's dance?
It was just, no, he wrote him, the tattoo guy.
But I mean, did he suggest that you get a Let's Dance tattoo?
No, it was my idea.
Your idea? Okay.
Yeah. I had a, you get inspired.
Sure.
And by the way, I did just buy the official Sam Miller t-shirt, and it says Let's Dance right on the belly there. Yeah. It's the coolest, most unique merch I've seen from a comic in years.
I try to get my shirts. I also have these ones that say Sam Miller's seagull eggs on it. Because there's this thing that happened when I got sober. People would come up to me and be like, hey, I'm scared to ask you this, but is it true? Like, somebody told me that you were eating seagull eggs. And I had to tell people, no, that's a rumor. I was never eating seagull eggs. And if you want to, that's what it's like when you get sober after being really high for a very long time, is that there was a rumor going around that I was eating seagull eggs, which really hurt.
Yeah. Well, you had no way to fry them up anyway.
No.
Yeah, you would have had to rock them.
Well, and we've established the fact that you were couch surfing for a while.
Yeah.
And one of the couches outdoors.
Mm-hmm. On a porch. Yeah. People would ask me if I had a house yet, and I'd go, almost. 20 feet.
You're one of those outdoor friends that we've all had.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it was bad. I mean, I fell out of a tree one time.
How'd that happen, Sam?
I was at this house party, and I was drunk, and this girl showed up, and I owed her money.
Yeah?
And I knew she couldn't get up this tree, so I climbed up this tree. I brought some beer up the tree.
Yeah.
And it's weird. I like this story because I woke up in the hospital. Because I think there's a good story about addiction and alcoholism and that those who suffer from it is it. I woke up in the hospital. I don't remember what happened.
Okay.
And the doctor was like, Sam, I think we got to talk about this. I think it's time to make a change. And I was like, you're right. And I was like, I got to stop climbing trees.
Basically, that's the first of 12 steps.
Yeah. I had a tree problem.
I'm guessing the problem was gravity.
Yeah. It was bad. It was
Tom,
bad.
Have you seen one of his arm tattoos is a fish? What kind of fish is that?
It's a burbot.
Oh, a burbot.
Yeah. What's and then I got a flower.
Wait a minute. Hang on. Slow down.
What's a burbot?
What's a burbot?
It's like a freshwater ling cod.
Now, I had heard that you were eating burbot eggs. Is that true?
I don't know.
That's caviar in his world.
I don't live in a world of absolutes.
Sam Miller is our guest. Sam,
things happen.
Can I see your right arm? Can you hold it?
What's a machine gun
or something?
Yeah, that would be an AK-47 because I wanted to be a tough guy.
Uh-huh.
And then when I got sober, one of the jobs, so I had all these different jobs after I got sober in 2008. And one of them is I was an assistant. I worked at a preschool. I was like a preschool teacher.
Really?
And yeah, an assistant preschool teacher. And I had to wear a sock on my arm to cover up the gun tattoo because it would make parents uncomfortable and children curious. and it's a thing. Like, I love my life today. I'm a really good person. And even back then when I was getting high, I was still a good person. I was really sick, you know?
Yeah. And you made bad choices.
I made really bad choices. Yeah. But some of that stuff too, like I think about it, my dad died when I was 12. Like things went really sideways for a really long time.
Mm.
And that's the thing is like, I always say, I'm glad that I could put this out there. I didn't get high because I liked being high. I got high more because I hate the way I feel when I'm sober. Mm. I wasn't running towards something. I was running away from that feeling, you know.
You're feeling good?
Sometimes, yeah. I'm 51% good. Like, being a full-time stand-up comedian and a full-time dad and a full-time husband is a hard way to make a go of it in life. But things are looking up now. Look at me now. I'm on the Bob and Tom show. Yeah.
So now you talked about meeting your wife, kind of. So you're on your first date, such as it is. And you couldn't do your place or mine because your place was the street. How did you actually physically encounter her for the first time?
She let me come over, which was cool.
But I mean, did you just meet her on the street?
No, I was bouncing at a bar and she came in and she was big and she had tattoos and that's what I'm into. I like big women and I like big women with tattoos.
Uh-huh. Sure.
Yeah, and that makes sense because big women have more room for tattoos.
It's a wider canvas.
It's just more canvas is all that is.
Think about it. That's what I'm talking about.
Do you have a favorite one of hers?
She has a tattoo of her breastfeeding when she got it after our son was born.
Is it on her arm? Okay.
Yeah.
So it's not like a baby on her boob.
No, that'd be really hot.
That'd be really hot.
Yeah.
Wow.
But yeah, it was like I said, she let me move in after like 2 weeks, which was bad boundaries on her part, but is a sweet deal for me as a homeless guy. You know?
Sam Miller is from the Great Northwest and has an interesting background. First of all, in the foreground is your presence. You're a big fella.
Huge.
6'6", 370?
Yeah, I say 360 and I tell the treadmill 350.
Right, okay. Wow. But you're a big guy, so you're somewhat imposing right off the bat.
Yeah, and I'm working on, maybe I got a little bit too big during the pandemic, so I've been kind of like trying to take better care of myself. I got the sleep apnea.
Oh.
diagnosis. I was shocked. I was like, not me.
Do you have the Air Force mask you have to wear at night?
It's sick. I love it. I'm so good at CPAPing.
Like, oh, really?
Yeah, I love CPAPing. It's rad. And every morning I get a score, and I'm like, I did so good last night.
Yeah. So explain this to me. What kind of a score? How does it work?
AH1.
I got this thing. It measures, like, how many times I wake up. How many times, like, the leakage? Like, how much is coming out the sides?
Of your face?
No, your underwear.
Okay, yeah.
Boxer shorts.
Well, when you say leakage, you want to make sure.
It's not a drool factor.
Yeah. Or a urine.
Anal leakage.
Okay. I was a bedwetter, so I'm sensitive to these things. Yeah.
It's not even anal leakage. Isn't the topic.
Oh.
I'm ahead of the game.
My wife is pumped. Not snoring no more. Still farting a lot, but not snoring, you know? And, it's every morning I wake up and I go, wow, like, this is what it was used to be like. Like, you get used to it because I think the apnea gets worse over time and it's like a frog in boiling water. And then now I wake up and I go, whoa, like, hello, day, you know? And I do my yoga. It's
nice.
Cool. Yeah, yeah.
Does the machine make like a flop-a-flop-a-flop-a sound of some sort?
Mine's really quiet unless it's on my face weird, and then it starts hissing and stuff. But that's just its little reminder to put it back on, you know?
Pat, you wear one still?
Yeah.
Is yours fairly quiet?
It hisses a little bit.
Okay.
Like Sam's, yeah.
Is it relaxing, though? Like white noise?
It's the greatest. It's perfect.
Pat, I got to be delicate here. Say you're at an away game.
Yeah.
Do you bring it with?
You do.
That's got to be awkward.
It can't.
How big is this? Like in a suitcase? How big is this?
It's like the yay big. My hands are
radio.
The 10 inches apart.
So it's bigger than a football.
It's about the size of a headphone case. You know when you take your headphones on a plane? Because my mom has one.
Okay. So
had to move it.
Okay. So when you're on the road doing comedy, like you're going to be at McCurdy's in Sarasota this summer.
You take it with.
You'll take it with you.
And then do you have to carry water with you too? What's
distilled water.
Distilled water.
You don't have to run it with the water. You can run it dry.
Oh, you can?
Yeah, which didn't sound like a good way to say that, but yeah.
Going to bed dry, baby. Yeah.
Sam, and I have certain people in my life telling me that I maybe should go. Do you go to a doctor?
I took the test, and they told me, this lady at the sleep apnea place, you go and they put wires all over your body, you know, and it was really strange. And they told me that I stopped breathing 24 times in 1 hour. And it was weird because I felt like I was being attacked. So I told her I started breathing 24 times too.
Let's accentuate the positive here.
I think
25.
But it's been a game changer, you know. And I have a joke. I talk about that because then they told me, you know, you don't have the great insurance with the comedy stuff. And they were like, the machine's $1,500. But then I found a refurbished one for $400.
Mm. Oh.
It was like much cheaper. And the lady at the sleep apnea place, she was like, do you really want to put a mask on your face that was on someone else's? And I was like, well, I used to do meth. I think I'm going to be okay.
I drank my own piss to get high.
Seagull
is really nothing.
I was like, I'll be fine. Lady, you know?
So do you strap? Does it like got a thing in the back of your head? You strap it on?
Yeah, it's comfortable though. At first I was like, how am I going to be able to sleep with this thing on my face? But honestly, I should be like, how was I able to sleep with my mouth open, gasping for air?
Is it plugged into the wall or is it on batteries?
No, it's plugged into the wall.
So if you have to get up and pee, you got to take the mask off.
I got a big bladder.
You're not getting up at night to pee?
No, I don't get up at night to pee.
Let it rip in the bed there?
I just do one before, about to go to bed, do my pee.
He can hold it 8 hours. He's still young.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, those were the days, huh?
Yeah, right?
Oh, sure were.
Gotta write a song about that. I'm up again, naturally. Well,
I feel like I used to drink like tall cans.
Sure.
And I just slam them, you know? And then I like to see like how long I could wait before I peed. And then I'd see, because I love doing like really big pees. Like that was really fun.
How's it doing?
I was out by the railroad tracks. So there wasn't a lot going on.
That's a fun afternoon, man.
Yeah.
Did you time them? Do you have a record?
You know what I would do? This is, I've never talked about this before, but I would get like those 16-ounce beers and I would drink like, and then I'd pee in the cans to see, because I wanted to see like how much I was making.
What goes in, what comes out.
Yeah. And it'd be weird because I'd be like in an abandoned house pissing in a can, and I'd be like, I'm interesting.
If they could see me now.
Science. Fascinating. Sam, I know that you are in fact a professional comedian.
Correct.
And I applaud your professionalism.
Correct.
You're doing a very nice job. Now, you might take this the wrong way when we say that we would like to school you in comedy. And I always preface it by saying the same thing. Are you familiar with Mr. Tiger Woods?
Yes.
Fine golfer. But even at his peak, he would take... he would have a swing...
It's getting longer every day.
Yes.
I'm working over here. I'm trying. I want Sam to be comfortable because I can tell he's a little uncomfortable right now thinking something weird is going to happen. So Tiger Woods takes swing lessons much the way we're going to give you joke-telling lessons. Ladies and gentlemen.
Who's that sexy man with a deep voice? Ace Cosby. Joke of the day.
Sam, I'm dating a homeless woman.
I've been there.
We're getting kind of serious. Mm-hmm. She asked me to move out with her.
That was Ace Cosby's joke of the day.
That's pretty good.
Indeed. Ties into our theme. It's very
sure
good.
Sure does.
Very good. You know what else is very good?
What's that?
Omaha Steaks. Go to omahasteaks.com. Use code BTS at checkout. Get $30 off an unforgettable gift guaranteed to make your dad's day. That's Omaha Steaks. Because look, if there's one thing we know, it's that dads want steak. Isn't that right, Sammy?
Yeah.
You like Sammy?
Anything, really.
Yeah.
It's good. I wasn't ready. I didn't know you were going to talk to me real quick.
No. I
was like, he's doing the Omaha Steaks thing.
Just wanted to see if you could, talk off the cuff there, and no, you can't.
Sam,
I was thinking about Shania Twain.
Yeah.
Did you have a nickname when you were a kid?
People call me Big Sam. For a while, people called me Here's Good.
Here's Good.
Yeah, because I'd pass out in, like, bathrooms. And they'd be like, you can go sleep on the couch. And I'd be like, Here's Good.
You've got to title your first album Here's Good because it's so weird.
Oh, that's
no
great.
One's ever titled one that.
Here's Good is that's so great.
Oh.
For the record, I'm signed to Stand Up Records, so I am signed to a record label out of Minnesota. Wonderful label. They're fans of the show too.
Very nice.
Yeah. So I'm on my first album will be coming out. We're waiting. There's a backlog on vinyl, but my album's called Round Trip. So I got sober June 10th, 2008. And June 9th, 2008, I woke up under a tarp in front of a theater in downtown Olympia, and I recorded my comedy album at that same theater.
Oh, cool.
That's amazing.
Hell yeah, dude.
Yeah, it's really cool. And we were going to call it Full Circle, but there's already a comedian that had an album called Full Circle, a friend of mine, Tyler Bowe, good comedian. And... So we called it Round Trip.
Can we do Here's Good for the next album?
I kind of have ideas for the next. I was going to call it, I was thinking about calling it Tarp Stuff.
Tarp Stuff's very good too.
Yeah. But me and Dan Schlessel, he runs the label. I like sending him album titles. I'm like, what if we call the second album Dog Nipple Neutral? Which is a joke I'm working on. Yeah, because you know when dogs lay on their back and they want you to rub their belly,
right.
But you're actually rubbing their nipples, and I think it's weird.
Mm.
And so I do like tic-tac-toe.
We don't want to touch their nipples.
I'm like, I don't want to rub my dog's nipples.
I have to try that. Probably you could use that in the bedroom too.
Yeah.
A little tic-tac-tongue.
Does your dog ever point to his nipples and go, "Here's good"?
Not yet. We're done. He's 6'6", 370. He's a bad man, but very funny. His name is Sam Miller. He's on his first Midwestern swing, and among other things, he's going to be in Chicago doing three shows at the Laugh Factory. Massillon, Ohio at Crackpots, Friday the 16th. And that's Crackpots with a K.
Yeah, it is.
Cincinnati. And that's coming up Thursday of next week. Knoxville, Dayton, and more. So once again, check it out. How do you get it, Willie? What's
the go to Sam Miller Comedian on Instagram. There's a link there. Or go directly sammillercomedy.com. The Don't Tell shows, you made it sound confusing. It is not, y'all. You go on there, you click a link, you can go see Sam.
Anything confusing. It's my great gift.
Oh, I'm glad you recognize that. that's a talent.
I don't recognize that. I just get told it constantly.
I'm sorry.
Well, maybe somebody's right. We were talking to Sam about his various things. You've been in jail. You've been sober for 15 years tomorrow, which is awesome.
Very cool, yes.
And you had a real rough go there for a while.
Yeah.
You mentioned you were a bouncer.
Mm-hmm.
Were you ever a bouncer at a comedy club?
No, I wasn't. I was a bouncer at a bar called McCoy's in Olympia, Washington.
Did you ever bounce anybody?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and I was bounced a few times myself. it was a rough spot, but it was a beautiful spot. I don't know. I saw some wild stuff, you know. I remember one time there was a snowstorm, and a guy walked down the street with water skis on his shoulder during the snowstorm.
Cool.
And he was like, "Can I come in?" I was like, "I don't think so, man. Like, you look like you're kind of on one." And then he looked back and he was like, "Fine, none of us will come in." And he goes, "Come on, guys." And he went down the street. But there was nobody behind
him. Nobody behind him.
That was sweet.
That's a party.
Yeah, forget this place. There was a guy, we had a paint huffer that tried to come in one time.
Sure.
And I don't disparage anybody. I used to huff a little bit myself.
But Josh is a taint huffer.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. I'm trying to quit, but it's hard.
But this guy comes in and he smells like paint really bad. And I feel bad. Like, I'm a softie, you know. I feel bad for the guy. And I was like, "I'm sorry, man. I can't let you in." I asked him, I was like, "Have you been huffing paint?" And there was
a pause.
No. There was like this big pause, and then he goes, "No."
No, you said you were in jail in Yakima?
Yeah, that was the worst place I was ever locked up, and it's not even close.
When you said that, I don't know much about jail, but I looked it up. It only got 1 star on Yelp.
Yeah.
Must be a real dump.
Yeah.
Okay, we have a couple things we have to do here, Sam.
Time for our history lesson.
Who does the intro on this?
Time now for history and such.
Okay, what day is today?
Today is June 9th.
Okay, I gotta find it. Give me a break here.
It is
okay, here we go. Number. Oh, this is a good day.
Yeah.
In 1973, Secretariat won the Triple Crown.
Oh. Now known as Administrative Assistant.
Very nice, very nice. Let's go to some birthdays. 1672, happy birthday, Peter the Great.
Was he indeed great? What did he do?
Well, he started as Peter the Okay. Over the years. That's hard to live up to, isn't it?
Yeah.
Did he have that title when he was still there? Or would that be like calling it World War One before World War II started?
Can you imagine? This World War One is rough. One?
I heard that. They didn't call it World War One. When it was going on.
The Great War.
Yeah.
They call it the Great War, yeah.
Oh, here's some good news for Dean. Happy birthday, 1915, the great Les Paul.
Oh, yes.
Guitar fella.
Yeah, I used to shout out Les Paul more Ringo. That, by the way, was, that,
no
by the way, was
that.
Never, ever no. said.
The rest of the crowd looked at you and went, huh?
Actually, I do love Ringo. In fact, he's on tour. He's got Edgar Winter with him. Who else?
Ringo's doing fine.
It was
fine.
Just a joke. He wasn't calling anyway.
Okay, sorry. Ringo's out there. Happy birthday. Oh, this is weird. Happy birthday, Donald Duck.
Oh, how old is he?
1934.
Mm. Wow. So he's 90.
Not sure his age.
30 seconds. 89.
Okay. We have to review what we learned on today's show. Are you ready to do that?
I sure am. Yes. Today is, the things we learned on the show. Tom had a nice pre-show nap.
Yep.
One of these, pretty soon he'll wake up from it. I hit every red light this morning, but here's the deal, folks. Just because you hit every red light in the morning doesn't mean the day's over.
That's right.
It's just something that happens. Sam Miller has been our guest. He's been absolutely terrific.
Hey, Sam.
Sam Miller Comedian on Instagram. Sam Miller Comedy is where you find out where you can see him and go.
Where do you find his Let's Dance hat tattoo?
Right on his belly.
Belly. Yeah.
Does your wife have that on her belly?
No, she's got a bunch of other ones. Okay. We don't have matching tattoos.
Oh, I maybe know. It's time.
Yeah, it would be cool. She is very beautiful. I'm very lucky. Okay. And like I said, it was she invested in me. So.
Well, it's paid off.
Yeah. Yes.
All right. This is the Bob and Tom Show.
Hey.